The Philippine business community rallies behind the country's troops amid continued Chinese maritime aggression. A Friday joint statement of some 15 groups deplored the harassment of military and Coast Guard personnel, as well as fisherfolk in the West Philippine Sea. Businessmen also urged the government to move with urgency in building up the military's capabilities. Signatories to the statement include the elite Makati Business Club and the Management Association of the Philippines.
Four Chinese Army warships were spotted 12 nautical miles off Palawan Wednesday. The Philippine military says the vessels were all headed southwest of the Balabac Strait. It adds the ships responded accordingly when challenged. This comes as Manila's defense chief launches the first two vessels under the Navy's corvette acquisition program. The two corvettes were supplied by a South Korean firm, Hyundai Heavy Industries. Secretary Gilbert Teodoro Jr. says his agency is committed to partnering with nations strategically aligned with the Philippines. The Philippine Health Department deactivates Code Blue as cases of vaccine-preventable diseases such as pertussis and measles continue to decline. The DOH logged a 38% decrease in pertussis cases between late April to May. Measles cases also dropped 37% in that period. Philippine Health Secretary Ted Herbosa cites continuous efforts to sustain routine vaccinations. The DOH raised the Code Blue alert last March 20 amid an increase in cases.
The tariff cut on rice now official. President Marcos has issued Executive Order 62, reducing import duties on unhusked milled and semi-milled rice from 35% to just 15%. The National Economic and Development Authority had announced a tariff reduction earlier this month. With this, the government hopes to substantially ease the upward pressure on domestic prices of the staple grain. The Philippine Resupply Mission was not the only operation subjected to harassment by the Chinese Coast Guard. Commodore Jay Tariela, Philippine Coast Guard spokesperson on the West Philippine Sea, revealed their own personnel were also blocked and intimidated from rescuing the injured personnel of the Philippine Navy. Tariela adds, despite their repeated calls and appeal to the Chinese Coast Guard to allow them to carry out their medical mission, Chinese ships continued to carry out dangerous maneuvers. These actions, according to Tariela, delayed their mission to bring injured Filipino soldiers to a medical facility. Tariela pointed out their emergency evacuation took 12 hours to complete.
And then for the AFP personnel who were injured, it's only around 10:30. Nang nakuha natin yung mga injured natin na AFP personnel. It's because despite of our coordinating efforts to the Chinese Coast Guard to retrieve the injured AFP personnel, we were still subjected to a dangerous maneuver and harassment from the Chinese Coast Guard, and not just the Chinese Coast Guard. We were also harassed by PLA Navy vessels like the Hubei-class missile boats. Ang rib na ginamit natin was actually harassed by the Chinese Coast Guard ribs. We had the hard time to outmaneuver them and even to convince them to allow the Philippine Coast Guard rib to retrieve our injured AFP personnel.
The Philippines touts the country's efforts to improve its fiscal incentive system before Japanese investors. This reassurance made Friday by Manila's finance chief Ralph Recto during the Philippine economic briefing in Tokyo. He says a proposal to improve the corporate recovery and tax incentives law will address key issues in the Philippines' investment climate. This would also exempt export-oriented enterprises from paying value-added tax, which has been a long-standing concern among Japanese investors. Recto also presented measures to encourage foreign partnerships. These include amendments to the Public Service Act, which allow full foreign ownership of public services, and to the Foreign Investments Act.